the icy plains of Grand Forks, North Dakota. Not exactly a place most of us think of as cutting edge, until you look up. That's the sound of an unmanned aircraft system, or UAS, or what many of us refer to as a drone. By propeller, on wings, sometimes catapulted into the sky, these tiny aircraft hum daily high in Grand Forks' skies. The Sheriff's Department has deployed its four UASs to help bust a sex predator and search for a man who went missing in this flood. Deputies deployed their UASs alongside choppers and found the truck, though the driver had died. Drones fighting street crime, delivering your packages? Not a flight of fancy, says North Dakota, one of six FAA test sites for unmanned aircraft systems.
Has the future of UAS technology already arrived here?
Here, yes. We are as far out in front of the nation as it can be.
And it's continuing to race ahead, says Executive Director Robert Beckland. Part of the reason is Grand Forks is home to the U.S. military base that houses the Predator drone. The explosion in drone technology is now meeting a commercial craving to deliver to your front door. But here's the challenge. When this beer company jokingly showed off its homemade beer drone, the FAA grounded it because it hasn't figured out how to fly drones safely amid all the other flying objects in our airspace.
When the Wright brothers were making airplanes, they had no idea how they were going to be used in the future. Same thing with these unmanned aircraft.
The technology is undeniably cool, but here's where some people are getting cold feet about it. It's small, it's relatively stealth, and you can easily attach a camera to it. That camera, which in many cases streams high-def video live to the controller, raises huge privacy concerns. During testing, pilots here must post these signs so you're on notice. Not that we could find any locals worried about it.
I don't think they're, you know, hovering in my backyard or anything, looking through my window.
Privacy won't stop the inevitable, say these University of North Dakota aerospace students, among the first in the country getting a degree in UAS piloting.
I see this as probably the same sort of revolution that happened when the jet engine was invented, and it's going to change aviation and the rest of the world that much.
Kyung Lah, CNN, Grand Forks, North Dakota.